Hello from the Bureau. I'm climatologist Lynette Bedio.
And I'm hydrologist Robert Pippenich. We're here to discuss the climate and water outlook for November to February. So Lynette, it's been a pretty dry year so far. What are the current drivers that are affecting our climate as we go towards summer?
Well, we're still seeing the impacts of that really strong positive Indian Ocean dipole. Positive Indian Ocean dipole usually brings warmer and drier conditions to Australia, which we're certainly seeing this year. Mm-hmm. But we should see that signal start to break down as the monsoon moves down into the southern hemisphere. Now we're also seeing the impacts of a negative southern annular mode, and that's pushing warmer, drier winds across eastern Australia and cooler winds across western Tasmania.
Okay, so that combination, the positive Indian Ocean dipole, the negative southern annular mode, what impact is that likely to have on our rainfall?
Well, we can see this reflected in our rainfall outlook. So for the end of November, there are really strong tendency towards below average rainfall across much of the country there. But then as we do move into summer, not quite as strong a signal in our rainfall outlook, though there are some parts of eastern Australia that still have that increased chance of below average conditions.
Okay, and given that generally dry outlook and the last couple of months where we saw fairly low rainfall, a lot of the catchments around Australia have got very dry soils. So the chance of generating any runoff into streams is reduced. And we're seeing this in our streamflow outlook. So you can see most of these orange dots here. That's roughly 95% of locations likely to have low flows for that November to January period.
Yeah, that's a lot.
Yeah, it's quite compelling to have that many in that one category. Yeah, so, all right, fairly dry conditions, low flows. How about temperatures for summer?
Well, we're seeing a really strong signal in our temperature outlook as well. So for summer daytime, temperatures really increase chances of above average daytime temperatures across much of the country. And this really does increase the chance of an early season heat wave like we're currently seeing in northern parts of Australia. And also coupled with those dry conditions, any days with strong winds will again set the stage for dangerous bushfire weather. So please keep an eye on our website and listen to guidance from local emergency services.
Really important message there. Thanks, Lynette. That's it from us for now. Join us again next month for our climate and water conversation.